Love, peace, and soul. What's going on? It's Empress. Empress Gem, y'all. This is another reading. A twin flame personal reading for our second divine masculine that done reached out. Woohoo! Give him a round of applause. Yes, finally. Thank you so much for your patience. You are so wonderful. And I'm going to go in on your reading. Okay? No matter how long it take, you're going to get your reading, and it's going to be your money's worth. And people even reach out to me even after, and we still have conversations after. So, you know, I give way more than even what the price. It's like I said, it's an exchange. You understand? I learn from you just like you learn from me. Okay? So now, a lot of swords energy, a lot of, you know, thought patterns, weighing up options, you know, wanting to communicate, but first deliberating in your mind, you know, what y'all want to do, how y'all want to move on, you know, what needs, let me see that, okay, what needs to be created. Okay. It's hot. I'm hot. I think because you both of you have other options. There's a possibility for there to be other options. In love. Hold on. Now. You're an eight. Hard knock life. Libra. So you know, you learn about yourself through your partnerships with others. Okay, that's how you get to know yourself. Okay. Let me pull. You want a Kama Sutra? I know you want a Kama Sutra.
Everybody wants a Kama Sutra, baby. Hold on.
Okay. We're going to start off with your divine feminine. She got the Two of Wands and the Strength card. I'm going to show you in a minute. Right? Okay, again, she's weighing up options. More like what direction she wants to go into in her life. She feels like she is finally coming to an epiphany. She feels like she's finally coming into her feminine power. You know, she's been through some dark times, and she's learning how to control her lower nature. She's learning how to control her lower chakras, right? The lower self, the ego, okay? Okay. Again, two is prevalent. Let's see, how can I do this now with this stupid light? Okay, don't worry, I'm gonna get the formula. Wait, that you can't really see. Hold on. Trying to get that glare right. Because this deck, this is a new deck called the Spellcaster's deck. And it is so visual. Like, y'all got to see. Y'all see the snake? She got a wand in her hand. Okay. There's a snake, and then there's like, this looks like a lotus flower in the middle of the river. Okay, let me hold it like that. There you go. All right? You know, she's, like I said, she's coming into her, in tune with herself. And also, you know, she's learning about you, too. You know, she's learning about this connection between you two. She seems, I don't know if she's an animal lover or she could be a Leo. Is she a Leo or a fire sign? But, and then the cat in there, that's straight spiritual femininity. So she's definitely coming into herself. Now you got the Two of Swords and the King of Pentacles. Right? Now, again, weighing up options. See, I'm going to have to hold it on an angle. Weighing up options. I can't see. Oh my God, I'm going to have to get this shit right. All right. You see the Two of Swords here and the King of Pentacles. And you're on the verge of maybe a new financial opportunity, you know, with having people working for you, or if you already have people that work for you, and, you know, you don't want to leave her out of your decision making. There may be an opportunity to make more money, but it may mean travel. And you may have even offered to her, like, you know, do you want to come? You know, come out here. I don't know if you guys are at a distance from each other. And you made an offer, maybe, and she has to deliberate. And then now you're waiting. You may feel like you're waiting for her decision, but it's impacting, you know, your financial status. And she has the Three of Swords and the King of Wands. Okay. So I think she's coming out of a depressed time, a depressed mind state. I think now she's really wanting to take control of the direction of her life as well. I don't know if the heartbreak is coming from you or from something else, but I think that she definitely has spiritual help. The angels and fairies, I think, are helping her to heal from, you know, these past hurts and pain that she's been holding on to, that she's been doing her alchemical work, you know, to try to get past. And then with this King of Wands, it's making me feel like maybe that's the other person. Maybe she's in a relationship with a fire sign, and maybe he hurt her. And she's deliberating whether to stay or to go with you or to stay with him. Possibly. Now you got the Queen of Swords and the Empress together. Hold on. I hope y'all didn't hear all that screaming, but if y'all did, I'm sorry. Okay. The Empress is very, very fruitful. That's why I resonate with this energy so much. Look at that. That's me all day, every day. Right? So, you know, this is someone. Now you got two female energy here. You got the Queen of Swords, and then you also got the Queen of Cups. Right? Which we'll get to, but that's why I said you have options too. And, you know, the Empress is very, very creative. She's very not only nurturing, she's also sensual. She's the ultimate earth mother. She's the healer. She's the nurse. She's everything. Okay. I don't know. And then the Queen of Swords is, you know, is kind of like the, you could say, divorce card. I don't know if you're getting a divorce, wanting a divorce, because you want the Empress energy. You don't want you know, someone who's going to be cold and cutting. You don't want someone who's going to, that's not going to warm up to your emotions. Someone, and then also the Empress resonates with Libra as well. So that bodes for partnerships too. You know, you're wanting a stable partnership. Someone that you can work through in all areas. Someone that you can communicate with freely and from the heart. Now, your Divine Feminine, she got the Eight of Wands and the Page of Swords. This is screaming communication. This is either she's going to be coming to you very soon with her answer about this offer, or, you know, or maybe she's going to get... I feel spirit messages. Like, I think that she's going to be getting, like, synchronicities. She's going to be seeing signs as far as this connection in order to further, you know, to show her what path she's supposed to take. It's not going to be this divine union, you know, this is not easy. It's not. Okay, sometimes we get caught up. We may be part of a divine union. We may get caught up in the wrong person. You know, we may get caught up in our own healing, caught up in a rejection. You know, our family, friends, everything, our whole life and paradigm is changing. So I think that, you know, she's going to read, as I said, I think she's receiving spirit help from fairies, from angels, from ancestors. And she's going to be getting messages from the spirit realm, you know, to show her and to be able to guide her into what direction she should go into. Now, you got the Wheel and the Queen of Cups. Okay, so things are going to turn. Fate is going to point you to this Queen of Cups, this compassionate woman. I don't know if this is your beloved, but I think so. You know, she's poised. She has her emotions in check, and she's not afraid to show them, but with tact. Okay, she knows when it's a time to cry, a time to laugh, a time to joke. You know, she knows how to temper her anger even. You know, the Queen of Swords just spits. She don't care. If she's mad, she's just going to say what she want to say. Doesn't care if it hurts you or not. You know, or maybe that's your energy. Okay, and maybe that's why your beloved got this heartbreak. Maybe something you said or communicated or did, maybe you did it without tact, and you know, and she got heartbroken by it, and maybe there was a separation because of it, you know. But she's going to be getting spirit messages, you know, about how you truly feel. Maybe your fate is turning in your favor for you to see about your feminine side as well, you know, because you're supposed to be the King of Cups. That's the archetype. That's the, you know, the attributes that you're supposed to learn to display, you know, in this life, within this union, for not only you, your partner, but the collective. And maybe you're at the stage of the Queen of Cups, which is very good, because that means that you've done a lot of work. You've done a lot of cutting. You've done a lot of clearing. Okay, you got the King of Pentacles. Maybe you're more stable now. Okay, you're more stable. You've been trying to feel your way through with the intuition, learning how to hone it, learning how to receive messages as well from spirit for yourself. Okay, so you've done a lot of progress. You should be proud of yourself, you know. It's just that the Divine Feminine gotten used to the rejection so much that now that all of this communication is going to be coming in, it's like, it's hard for them. It's hard for the Divine Feminine to, you know that it's true or to believe it. Now, the outcome is the Four Cups and the Tower. Yo, this illustration, I wish I could show. Good God. The glare. Okay. Okay, what I was trying to say is that, like, this spellcaster deck reminds me of the Bible Book of Stories. If you was raised Jehovah Witness, you know about them Bible Book of Stories. Okay, the illustrations are ill. Okay, it's, there's one person usually in the depiction. There's two people falling from the tower, but they were smart. They came out the bottom. They, it's like they dug their way out. And they like, oh, no shortcuts. No shortcuts, homie. Get back in there. You got to fall from the top like everybody else. Oh, wait a minute. But that might be another woman. That looks like another, that looks like the third party. That looks like the other woman. Okay? So you're definitely cutting ties with whoever you've been with. And then this looks like your divine feminine that's like, you know, that's working with you to escape all of this. And with the Four of Cups, you know. Damn it. It's the glare. Okay. All right, it's like the mermaid. I feel like that's your divine feminine. Like, she's feeling dissatisfied. Like, I've been offering you this cup all this time. You know, I've been here waiting for you. And it's like, you're like, okay, I'm just now starting to notice these two cups. You know, I've been trying to play the three, you know, have more than one partner in my life. And now I'm knowing that I got to get rid of the one of these cups. Right? I'm noticing that there's a union with these two cups, right? And she's there holding hers, like, well, when you gonna accept mine? I think that, you know, you was either you or both of you were trying to take the easy road. Like, you know, basically just have a secret relationship maybe while she has someone or you have someone and y'all like, well, let's just connect because, you know, the connection is too strong. But spirit is like, no, y'all can't, no. Y'all gonna have to clear who you need to clear out your life in order for you to be happy, in order for y'all two to be together. Subconsciously, there's a feeling of feeling trapped. You know, you're passionately wanting to be free, wanting to express how you feel. Okay, wanting to be intimate with each other. Like, again, dichotomy, right? The Knight of Wands and the Eight of Swords, right? Masculine, feminine. So she's waiting on you to come and give that communion. She's waiting for you to come. She's waiting on you to be like, come and claim me. Period. Come and claim me. I've been waiting. Now, what divination system that may help her is numerology, precision. Okay? There's so many different modalities of learning. Numerology, precision. Everything you have worked for hangs in the balance. So it is vital that you go through every detail thoroughly. You cannot afford to make errors at this time. Focus and precision will help achieve the results you desire. If you are serious about eliminating debt, step away from poverty consciousness and negative thinking. If you want to draw more money to you, clean and organize your physical environment so as to make room for it to come. Keep a record of all your expenditures. Draw up a profit and loss sheet to record your income and expenses. Check your bank statements carefully. Research utility and other companies to find the best rates. It's time to take back control. My head's no longer in the sand. I'll focus on the task in hand and check each detail of my debt so nothing will slip through the net. Your accuracy wins you a sought-after position. Number sequences confirm a message. That's what I was saying. A number sequence that she's going to be seeing numbers. This is what she's going to be going through. Signs and synchronicities. Okay. Her head is no longer going to be in the sand. She's going to be taking back control of her life. Okay. And then with you, you know, getting your money, you got your money together. You like, hold on. I can't, excuse me, carry the weight of both of us. Right. Okay. An important event coincides with an auspicious date. Keep visualizing a preferred balance on your bank statement. And now you got the scrying mirror projection. That came, that one's a nice one. Hold on. You currently desire something so strongly. Your focus is currently blinkered and you cannot see the pitfalls that might come from achieving your goal. The scrying mirror card reveals that your obsession for possession has blinded you to some negative aspects of your goal. It is vital to be clear, completely clear about what you wish for. Hold on. I didn't even give you your nickname. I'm so sorry. I'm so sorry. It's just been a lot. As we all know, as we are all going through. Your nickname is Thought. Okay? T-H-O-T-H. Right? Now, he's the Kemetan deity for communication. You know, for that Mercury energy. You know, I thought it was fitting with all the swords energy and you being an air sign as well. I said, okay, Thoth. That's what came to mind. God, I can't believe I didn't tell you that in the beginning. Sorry. But, you know, it is vital to be clear, completely clear about what you wish for, lest someone, including yourself, is harmed in the process of gaining it. Monitor your thoughts and words at every moment, as what you give out will come back to you threefold. Gaze long and deep within, intending to truly understand your ambition. When you recognize that everything that happens is merely your projection, your focus will change. And a reflection of the love in your heart will dazzle others. The love in your heart. That's the Queen of Cups. And ultimately yourself. My heart is finally set free from thoughts of how I must have to have it be. Mirror, mirror, as I scry, I see my one true love, 'tis I. Be careful what you wish for. You must learn to love yourself before you can truly love another. An unhealthy behavior or obsession does not serve you. Dig deeper to uncover the truth. Someone is projecting their doubts and fears onto you. Again, too, you know, being careful what you say. You know, not to burn any bridges. That's the Queen. God damn it. You know, let me see if I could do that without breaking it. Okay. The Queen. You know, learning to be compassionate in your communication. Right? Gotta be careful what you wish for. Because it may just happen. You know, you like, well, maybe it can work with all three of us. And then it not being able to work out that way. Okay, now let me give you your crystal. She has appetite, number 19. Appetite. Appetite works at the interface between consciousness and matter to let go of what is outworn in your life. Clear away confusion or guilt. Accept the truth about yourself. You're a complex being with credits and deficits. Recognize without judgment. Move away from aloofness or social alienation and show others who you truly are. Use your... This is like the third time I've seen this word. Hold on. Where's my pen at? I got to underline this and look this one up. That's what that means. You have much to offer by way of service as you access insights for the creative good. Be inspired. Discern truth within. Recognize what is real in your world and restructure reality. Don't be deceived by false fronts. See what is beneath. Develop your metaphysical perception. Things improve steadily. Understand that circumstances are merely learning opportunities. It's time to be of service to others. Teach what you know. Timing, Gemini. Soul path, discerning the truth within. Okay? That's her. The truth within herself. Of her power. Of who she is. Damn it. Okay. I'm gonna get this right. This position. Okay, now you got ancestrite. Ancestral light, that's 47. And let's see, shit. Right. The ancestors. Ancestral light has been radically modified during its time on Earth. It helps you to find the treasures hidden in your past. It takes healing way back and brings forward soul learning, rolling it into the future, but letting go of the experiences that created it. Any dis-ease you're carrying is ancient and has passed down through the ancestral line. It relates to prevailing attitudes and forbidden emotions that have been kept firmly repressed, as well as the ancient traumas and family dramas. Take note of your dreams. Family secrets come to the surface. A radical rethink is called for on all that you think, believe, and allow yourself to feel. The ancestors are all those who have gone before, not just your bloodline. Heal them and heal yourself. Soul path, manifesting the gifts from the past. Okay? Manifesting the gifts from the past. You know, this is like the turn of the wheel. The wheel is like, you know, time and space. Okay? The different seasons, the different timings, you know? Okay. Kama Sutra. Your beloved got the Six of Pentacles. And, you know, this is her wanting equality and even exchange, you know, wanting to show you how she feels about you. You know, she doesn't want to hold it back anymore. She's tired of holding it back. She wants to be able to show you how she feels about you. You got the Two of Pentacles. Okay, this is stable energy. This is the Merkaba. As above, so below. As within, as without. Okay? So this is, you know, you wanting to be in balance with your divine feminine. This is, yes, you were juggling, you know, probably juggling another relationship. But you have come to the conclusion of who you really and truly want. You know, what you two are capable of creating together. She got show simple acts of kindness. And in that card of the crystal, it says for her to teach what she knows, to show what she knows. Like I said, maybe she's an animal lover. Maybe her calling is to work with animals. Okay? Or some type of, you know, wildlife preservation. That's number five. Definitely see animal lover. One of the amazing aspects of being loving is that love also supports us. It is good to remember that when we are kind to others, we look for more opportunities to show kindness. When others are kind to us in return, we are motivated to pass that kindness on. Take a moment to show kindness and bring more love into the world. Okay? And you got spiritual connection. You see that? That's beautiful. Okay? That's why you reached out for, like, you know, for the divine masculine to reach out. You know he knows what's going on. This relationship has a connection that goes beyond this lifetime. Everything happens for a reason. Know that some of the people that come into our life are there just to help teach us a lesson and make a real impact on our life. Whether this is a love, soulmate relationship, or a relationship for growth, it is important to you in this lifetime. Okay, you're going to learn. You learn so much from your counterpart. Y'all learn so much from each other, you know, that, like I said, it doesn't matter in what capacity. Yeah, that's why I'm like, I don't want to use the word twin flame anymore. I think I'm going to renounce that title. Because you cannot label a spiritual experience. You really and truly can't. You are limiting it. And, you know, just enjoy the experience. You see here, they're dancing, you know, down here. It looks like they're taking a stroll in the park. You know, it's those experiences that you have with each other, you know, the good and the bad. You learn, you know, so much about yourself. You learn so much about the other. You learn so much about just being connected and knowing that the spirit world comes first, you know. It'll definitely bring about growth in your life. You know, people, like you said, it may be they, because they may be an agitator. They may be a catalyst for you to change, to change yourself. And that's the only thing that's constant in this world is change. Okay. So she's coming into her divine power. Also, you are healing the past. Whatever dissatisfaction that happens, whatever breakdown, whatever illness, maybe, okay, maybe that's what it said. Maybe that's what it is. And then the Empress is the healing aspect, you know, using herbs and different natural modalities, you know, to help with the healing of something that you brought in from another life with you. Okay, because you don't want it to come in the way of your prosperity. Yeah, because it's your time. It's your time, you know, for things to come your way, to swing fate into your direction and in the direction of the divine feminine. You know, because she's finding her inner truth of who she is. And sometimes it takes for time apart. It may take a time of you know, shaking up. She was shaking up, you know. But now it's time for that passion to come in, to renounce the indecision, to renounce the self-limiting behaviors, you know, for her to move, you know, with razor-sharp precision, okay, with these messages that she's going to be receiving from her angels, from her guides, okay? And again, you're coming out of it again, 51-49% rule. If you trying to decide what direction you're going to go into, you know, there's always that 1%. Which option has that 1% rule? Okay. Whatever leans to the 51%, that's what you're gonna have to choose, you know. All right, Thor, thank you so much. Please email me with your response. Let me know how you received this message. Peace and love.